In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to install Magic 360 in Magento. You can see the product image currently looks flat on my page, so I want to change that from this to this. Look how impressive my image looks now, with a 360 spin, so customers can see every angle of the product. Add to that the magnify effect, and you have the ultimate zoom tool for selling products. To get this effect, we need to go to the Magic Toolbox website. If you go to the Magic 360 product page, you'll see the Magento icon on the right hand side, which will take you to the Magic 360 for Magento page. Click the download button and save the zip file to your computer. Extract all the files, and the Magic 360 folder is what we'll upload to our server. I'm going to use FileZilla for this. Find the Magic 360 folder on your computer and upload it to the Magento directory on your server. This will take a few minutes, so pause the video here and start again once your folder is uploaded. My files have now finished uploading and you can see my Magic 360 folder is showing here. Next, we need to disable the compilation process. We can do this by going to System, Tools, Compilation. You can see my compiler status is enabled, so I need to disable it. Next, we're going to install Magic 360. To do this, enter your Magento website URL and after it enter Magic 360. You'll be taken to this page and all you have to do is click Install. Now go back to the compilation page we were just on, and this time click Run Compilation Process. Of course, if you don't use the Magento compiler, then you don't need to do this step. Next, we need to clear the cache. Go to Cache Management, select all, make sure the action says refresh, and click Submit. You can see on my shoe product, I've uploaded all my images to make the 360 degree spin. I'm using 36 images for this. You can also see I've put each image in the sort order I want them to appear on my product page. Next, we need to go to the settings page and tell it which products we want Magic 360 to work on. The default is set to all, but you can change this by entering each product ID. You'll also need to state how many images you'll be using to achieve your spin. I'm using 36, so I'll leave this as it is. Magic 360 is now installed. If you refresh your product page, you'll see it in action. Remember to only upload large images as they'll be used for the magnify effect. Magento will automatically resize the large images to fit other areas of your website. Now that Magic 360 is installed, let's make a couple of changes. First, I'm going to remove the magnify option. Then I'll change the text which appears under the image. To do this, go to the Magic 360 settings page. Change the magnifier effect option to no. Go to message under images and type here what you would like to appear. If we go back to the product page and refresh, you can see the magnify option is no longer available and the text has changed under my image. To see what looks great on your Magento website, try all the options on the settings page. As well as adding Magic 360 to your product pages, you can also add it to your CMS pages. Go back to the Magic 360 settings page and select Yes for the Include Headers on All Pages option. This will bring in the CSS and JS files to your CMS pages. You can see at the moment my home page is blank. To change this, go to CMS pages, select the page you want, choose content, and select the HTML icon. This will open a HTML window. Next, go to the Magic 360 integration page. Go to the Referencing Images section. If you only want to have a spin effect, use this code. To have the spin and magnifier effects, scroll down to the Magnifier section. copy the example code and paste it into your HTML window. The H reference is the large image which will be your magnifier effect. Then there's the Magic 360 class. The rel attribute file name will pick up all your small images in sequence. Magnify is set to true, and the magnify file name attribute will pull in all your large images in sequence. Remember, if you've saved your images in a folder on your server, you'll also need to reference that. And finally, the image source is the small image, which will appear on your web page. Once you've entered your details, click Update and save your page. Now, if we refresh our home page, you can see Magic 360 is now working. At the top of each page on our website is a Contact Us link. So if you have any questions about any of our tools, just get in touch. If we're not online when you send your message through, we'll get back to you the very next day. And that brings us to the end of this tutorial. Thanks for watching.